Ulrach Branthan served as a captain of the Iron Hands Legion during the Great Crusade and Horus Heresy. Commanding the 65th Clan Company of the Iron Tenth, Ulrach's deeds prior to the Civil War for Humanity would be lost to time. As a survivor of the Dropsite Massacre of Istvaan V, Branthan would, despite being severely injured during the battle, rally many of his legion and orphans of the 18th and 19th legions to board the void ship, the Sisypheum. Escaping the Istvaan system, Ulrach would be treated for his injuries by the apothecaries of the Sisypheum. Losing both legs, one arm, and receiving multiple mortal injuries during the battle, his body would be broken beyond all hope of repair. Yet with no dreadnought chassis or sarcophagus available to house their valiant captain, the Iron Hands would look to the past for a means to heal their commander. Clamping the Dark Age of Technology artifact, the Heart of Iron, to Ulrach's body, the parasitic mechanism would at first seem unresponsive, yet with closer observation, proved to slowly be regrowing Branthan's damaged organs. This miraculous regeneration would come at the cost of Branthan's vitality and would with time inevitably kill its subject. Sustaining Branthan within a stasis field, the now Orphans of War would seek guidance from their leader and harry the traitor legions across several war zones. Confronting the Iron Warriors and Emperor's Children upon the world of Idris, they would deploy their stalwart ancient dreadnought, Karashi Bombastus, to destroy their foes. Failed by the Iron Warriors' Warsmith dreadnought, Berossus, Bombastus' dreadnought chassis would be recovered by the Orphans of War and seem a fitting housing for their wounded leader. Yet without the integration of a dreadnought sarcophagus, the Orphans of War would integrate Ulrach's maimed body using a cable-wound cocoon and sutures of his exposed flesh. Joining his stalwart battle brothers one last time during their mission to retrieve the Primarch's genetic materials from the moon of Luna, the Orphans of War would make their final stand. Alongside his lieutenant, Cadmus Tyro, the Iron Hands commanders would face the Justarian elite of the Sons of Horus and allow for the escape of Nykona Sharokin and the Magna Mater materials. Falling in battle, befitting a warrior of the Iron Hands, Branthan's long suffering would finally be over. His duty to his legion and Primarch, a monument to the endurance, strength, and fortitude of the Iron Tenth.